गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. यस्टरडे वी हैड डन अबाउट इकोनॉमी. व्हाट इज एन इकोनॉमी? अ सिस्टम दैट प्रोवाइड्स लाइवलीहुड टू इट्स पीपल, राइट, वेयर द थ्री बेसिक एक्टिविटीज ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, कंजम्पशन, इन्वेस्टमेंट आर अंडरटेकन. नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दैट दीज थ्री इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज, प्रोडक्शन, कंजम्पशन और इन्वेस्टमेंट, और यू कैन से कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन. ओके, द फर्स्ट एक्टिविटी विच इज मेनली परफॉर्म्ड इन एन इकोनॉमी इज प्रोडक्शन. Production, you would have done earlier also. Production is a process of converting raw material into finished goods, in which the raw materials are collected, they are processed, and then they are converted into finished goods. Okay, like in our kitchen also, mama prepares food for us. Okay, she takes the raw food and then she prepares, cooks it. She, through processes, she prepared many dishes so that you can have a taste on it and you can use them or you can consume them, right? So production is basically the process of converting raw material into finished goods, because we know very well that we can't consume directly all the resources which we are getting, right? They have to be processed so that they can be made, converted into useful form. Second activity is consumption. Consumption is the act or the process of utilizing goods and services for satisfying our wants. Okay, means if we are using goods and services, okay, like we are going to the doctor for hiring medical services, it is also consumption, because we are consuming, here we are taking the services. Okay, we are going to the market for buying food for us, or we are consuming it. Consumption means, consumption is the process of using goods and services. Third is investment or capital formation, right? Investment means addition to the existing capital stock of an economy, or we can say the process by which we add more assets to us, that is called investment. Okay, suppose you have three plots of land, big plots of land. Okay, in 1 year your parents have purchased one more land holding. Okay, this is called investment, or we can say capital formation. Okay, because what you have done, you already had three plots of land. Okay, now you have added one more into it. So total plots you are having four. So what we have done, whatever capital assets you had, you have added one more asset into it. That is called capital formation, or you can say investment. Like in our country, supposedly we have 16 nuclear reactors. Okay, now government has invested more and it has installed two more nuclear reactors in 1 year. So what has happened, that in 1 year we have added our nuclear capacity, two more nuclear reactors we have added. That is called investment, or you can say capital formation. Are you understanding? And this capital formation, or you can say investment, plays a very important role, because it increases our production capacity. More capital we'll have, more assets we'll have, the capacity of our production will be more. Are you understanding, children? Let us come to the new topic, central problems of an economy. What are the central problems? Central means basic. Here central means basic, right? Basic means these are such problems which you will find in every economy, be it a developed country like USA, any of the European country, be it Australia, be it Asia, any of the Asian countries including poor countries. Okay, but in every country we'll find some basic problems. In every economy, such problems are called central problems, right? Okay, we have done earlier also that in every economy faces scarcity of resources in one way or the other, right? Because you know very well, in our geography also we have done that resources are not evenly distributed. Somewhere we have very rich reserves of the iron ore, somewhere we have very good reserves of coal, somewhere we have very good reserves of manganese, aluminium, and many more, right? So resources are not evenly distributed, and every kind of resources are needed in an economy. Okay, so this is called scarcity. Scarcity means, we know, we have done it earlier, that the supply of resources is less than their demand. That is called scarcity, and every economy faces it. Every economy. Okay, like somewhere, like in developed countries, we'll not go far. Well, we are going far. Let's go to Japan. See, in Japan, what is there? Japan is lacking any sort of natural resources. There you will find very less, because it is an island country. So it lacks natural resources. What it does? It imports all those natural resources from other countries. Then it processes it. Okay, but it has one more resource which is in abundance. That is capital, human capital. Are you understanding? So somewhere you will find, that's why it is more advanced. ओके दे इम्पोर्ट द रिसोर्सेज दे प्रोसेस इट प्रॉपरली एंड देन दे वर्क ऑन इट आई यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग सो इट स्कार्सिटी ऑफ रिसोर्सेज इज फाउंड एवरीवेयर एंड इट इज ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ स्कार्सिटी ऑफ रिसोर्सेज थ्री बेसिक प्रॉब्लम्स अराइज वॉट टू प्रोड्यूस हाउ टू प्रोड्यूस एंड फॉर हुम टू प्रोड्यूस आई यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग लेट्स सी अ बेसिक एग्जाम्पल मीन्स आर डे टू डे एनी ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल रिलेटेड टू आर डे टू डे एक्टिविटी सपोज यू हैव डिसाइडेड टू गो टू किचन देर आर फाइव मेम्बर्स इन योर फैमिली एंड यू हैव डिसाइडेड दैट नाउ आई विल प्रिपेयर ब्रेकफास्ट फॉर यू टूडे ओके सो एक्सेप्ट यू द अदर फोर आर डिमांडिंग वन इज सेइंग आई नीड आई एम इन अ मूड टू हैव सैंडविचेस ओके यू आर यू एंड योर फादर आर इन अ मूड टू हैव पराठास एंड योर मम्मा सेज दैट शी विल हैव ओट्स ओके सो यू योर फादर वॉन्ट पराठा योर मम्मा वॉन्ट ओट्स ओके योर ब्रदर सेज दैट योर ब्रदर और सिस्टर सपोज योर सिस्टर सेज दैट शी विल हैव सैंडविच नाउ योर ब्रदर विल से दैट he want let's say bread pakoda okay so now if you are going to kitchen then you will have to see that all the demands need to be fulfilled okay so you see now you have got a choice this what to produce problem now you have got that what type of goods you have to produce you have to produce parathas you have to produce you have to prepare oats okay and you have to prepare sandwiches and bread pakoda for five different people This is what to produce. Means you have to identify that what type of goods are needed in an economy or what type of goods are needed, what type of goods are people too ready to consume. See, if bread pakoda is in demand, oats are in demand, parathas are in demand, sandwiches are in demand, okay, and if you prepare idli then, if no one is willing to have idli, why to prepare it? Okay, so what to produce means what type of goods should be produced so that they are demanded in an economy. According to the need, the goods are produced. Second is how to produce. How to produce means what technique of production should be applied. And for whom to produce means ultimately you know very well that goods which are produced, they will be ultimately sold in the market. We'll buy it. Okay, and you know very well that everyone can't buy every kind of good. Okay, some people have lesser purchasing power, they have less money in their pocket, so they can't afford expensive goods. They'll buy less expensive one. Okay, and all those who have good purchasing power, those who are rich, okay, they can afford expensive goods also. So this is the problem of for whom to. So every economy faces these basic problems as they are basic problems. Aur ye kiski wajah se aayi hai? Scarcity of resources ke karan. Okay, so scarcity of resources is the root cause of every problem. And every economy faces these three central problems. What to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce.